Is Nibiru a problem in Yu-Gi-Oh? Well, I mean, realistically, no. I think there is a very complicated reason why it's not a problem in Yu-Gi-Oh, though. And so in today's video, I want to go over Nibiru as a card, why it is not ban-worthy, and why its existence in the game is actually a good thing overall, rather than it being a negative in general. So Nibiru as a card is freaking insane. If your opponent normal or special summons 5 times, Nibiru becomes live. And what Nibiru does is, it can tribute all monsters on the field, special summon itself, and then you give your opponent a token, and that token equals the attack and defense of all of the tributed monsters. So it's obviously pretty freaking insane. I mean, you're tributing literally every monster on field. Ignoring the card advantage aspect of it, it is a huge tempo swing in general, basically saying, if I Nibiru you, you probably are not going to be able to come back, and so I'll pass the turn over to you. Nibiru, just that interaction is freaking incredible. Again, ignoring a card advantage perspective, the amount of tempo lost through this card is massive. And so with that, obviously Nibiru is good. Obviously Nibiru is going to be played. But I think the real aspect behind it is the fact that, is this too powerful? Is the fact that you contribute every monster on the field, even though you're giving your opponent a token that doesn't realistically matter, even though it could be like insane numbers of attack. It doesn't realistically matter if your opponent doesn't end on anything in today's game of Yu-Gi-Oh! Think about it. Every deck basically is a break my board deck at this point. Even decks like Sky Striker end on disruption, and I say, hey, you have to get through my disruption, and then I have to reestablish. That is basically what I mean by every deck and every format is basically a break my board type of format. There is obviously back and forth because of this disruption, so you need to make sure you have ways to disrupt your opponent to eventually minimize the game state to a point where you can capitalize and finish the game from there. So with this mentality, combo decks are reliant on monsters in order to be able to disrupt the opponent. I think that's one big thing to note. Some combo decks don't rely on disruption, but that's okay. Most combo decks that I'm referring to that get hurt by Nibiru, like for example, Orcus. Orcus require a link monster in order for your Crescendo to be live, so you are reliant on monsters. Danger Thunder or Thunder Dragon decks in general rely on Colossus and monsters on field to make your Crescendo live, for your monsters to be able to negate stuff. So with that, Nibiru says nope to all of that, and you just slam down Nibiru, give them a token, and they say, I guess I can't end on disruption, so I'll pass. And then you're free to do literally whatever you want. So yeah, this is pretty freaking insane. This card in general does so much. I think obviously it's not as good against control decks, but that isn't the point of Nibiru. The point of Nibiru is to stop degenerate combo decks and combo decks in general. I think one interesting thing to note is recently we've had so much hate for control decks so that combo decks can play. Think about it, we've gotten cards like Twin Twister, Red Reboot, we've gotten Dango Sekka. These cards in general are counters to control decks. Some of them not as recent as others, but my point still stands. We've had evenly matched in the Link era. There have been quite a lot of cards, Hatrunate, stuff like that. Basically, my point is, there's been a lot more hate for control decks, in my opinion, that are directed specifically towards control decks than combo decks, and I feel the Megaton's purpose is to create that big hate for combo decks, just so that way there's more of a balance between hate cards for each side of things. So now we've established what the purpose of Nibiru is. The purpose of Nibiru is to stop combo decks, but I think one big interesting thing to note is the key difference between stopping degenerate combo decks and stopping healthy combo decks. So, and I think the perfect example of a degenerate combo deck versus a healthy combo deck is actually the comparison between Thunder Dragon and Danger Thunder Dragon. So by Thunder Dragon, I mean pure Thunder Dragon. So when we look at these two types of decks, Nibiru clearly stops both of them. But the difference is this. Nibiru actually creates pros and cons to both, whereas before you'd probably just pick the degenerate combo deck just because it gave you free wins. So, the degenerate combo deck, what are the pros? The pros are you get free wins. If you get a free win, that is huge going into a tournament because in the tournament you get a bunch of Swiss rounds, and so if you just get more wins, wins just because you resolve your combo, it's pretty unfair at that point, and so you're going to more consistently top. However, now with the existence of Nibiru, that creates cons to playing degenerate combo decks, and that is, you're going to lose games inherently just because your opponent had the Nibiru, or if you don't play Crescendo or anything, they had the Dark Ruler no more, stuff like that. I think Nibiru creates an interesting dynamic where, because degenerate combo decks have to commit so many resources at times to their play, let's take a deck like the Gardragon engine just in general. If your opponent is playing Danger Thunder Gardragon, then you summon your Gardragons, you've probably committed a decent amount of resources to that play, or at least two cards. And so Nibiru says, okay, I'm going to stop your LP, I'm going to clear your board, and not only that, I'm going to make sure you can't resolve LP for the rest of the turn, because remember, LP can only be special summoned once per turn, so that means that LP will not resolve for the rest of the turn, and this idea is saying that you've overcommitted to your play, and now you're getting punished for it. So I think that's the big aspect behind Nibiru, is that it actually punishes degenerate combo decks for playing, just because they don't have as many follow-ups afterwards. Now, if we've considered that degenerate combo decks don't get as many follow-ups, meaning they lose harder to Nibiru, then let's take a look at a deck like Pure Thunder Dragon. So while Pure Thunder Dragon isn't nearly as powerful as Danger Thunder Dragon in terms of their end board, it still ends on a really decent board, and you get hand traps with that. It's a lot more fair of a deck, there are counters to that deck. For example, Orcus is a big counter to Pure Thunder Dragon, like Orcus has an amazing Thunder Dragon matchup basically. However, that doesn't mean Thunder Dragon is a bad deck whatsoever. So, Thunder Dragon sets up Colossus Titan, let's just say that's the standard end board, right? Sometimes it's more, sometimes you end on it differently, stuff like that. However, the standard end board, Titan Colossus. Your opponent can then Nibiru you, but because of the way the deck works, you're going to have more inherent follow-ups. If you did not need to use Hawk that turn, let's just say for example, you can then go ahead and use Hawk, special summon one of your Thunder Dragons, and then just summon a Colossus from there. So, you're still like not ending on nothing, you're ending on a Colossus, and Colossus is freaking amazing, and you'll have that big as heck token just to beat down your opponent if they somehow can't clear it. Or, in other scenarios, you can actually just tribute the token for a Thunder Dragon monster if you've, let's say, not normal summoned this turn, and then you just special summon Colossus from there. My point is, even if you get Nibiru, you're going to have hand traps, you're going to have follow-ups, you're going to be able to end on a Colossus more consistently than not if you do get Nibiru. So I think that's my main point here. More fair combo decks don't actually lose to Nibiru as hard as you think. It is a tempo swing and it does deal with cards very effectively, but it is not the end of the game. It just means that, okay, my board's just gonna be more mediocre. That is the beauty of Nibiru. While it stops degenerate combo decks in its tracks, it says pure combo decks can play around Nibiru more effectively and still have follow-ups for the next turn and have a more back and forth game. Nibiru is a very interestingly designed card, in my opinion at least, and I think it is actually a really great card for the game. While it doesn't inherently kill combo decks, it doesn't kill healthy combo decks, it does kill degenerate combo decks. Now, one thing I will mention before I go, if you think that, oh, it's just an unsearchable 3 of, it doesn't matter, you can still play degenerate combo decks, think about it this way. You can see Nibiru 33% of the time. That means 1 out of 3 games you will see Nibiru. If someone is playing Nibiru, that means that, let's say it's in their side deck, games 2, they have a 33% chance of seeing it. Games 3, they have an even higher percent chance of seeing it out of the 2 games, so let's say it's like a 66% chance at that point, just to make things simple, right? If they will see it, if they have over a 50% chance to see it one of those 2 games, unless you won game 1, that is still a very high statistic, and it gets even higher with cards like Phantasme being able to draw into cards like Nibiru. Not only that, you just have other cards in the game like Super Polymerization to deal with boards, making Nibiru more accessible with Phantasme, but that also means you can see other cards like Super Poly in order to deal with the the boards, meaning you have 6 cards to deal with boards very effectively. In the end, do I think Nibiru is ban worthy? I do not think Nibiru is ban worthy if you want a more healthy game when it comes to combo decks. People have gotten the wrong idea of combo decks in the Link format just because combo decks have been so degenerate. Now, that's not me saying that combo decks can't be degenerate in the future. Like, for example, Pendulum is able to play around Nibiru super easily because of something like Servant of Endymion. However, I want to clarify that if a degenerate combo deck does not have an out to Nibiru and it's not easily accessible, then Nibiru is going to spell trouble for that deck. And realistically, I think that's why Nibiru is not ban worthy, because it stops degenerate combo decks, but it doesn't actually kill combo decks. It just stops the degenerate ones, creating a healthier game overall. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, I hope you enjoyed. What do you guys think? Was I correct about Nibiru not being ban worthy? Do you think Nibiru should be banned? What is your stance on Nibiru? I would love to know, put it in the comment section down below. If you want to support me further than just watching my YouTube videos, go down into the description and check out my Patreon. There is a $1 patron tier that I'd love for you to check out if you're interested in supporting me, and check out my TCG player affiliate link if you want to buy any singles on the market. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and with that, I hope to see you soon.